I'm going to show you exactly how, step by step, to set up your Chargeverter GC for the best possible outcome. And I'm going to give you all the parts that you're going to need for this. And at the end, I'm also going to tell you exactly why you must have the Chargeverter or some other charger like it so that you don't make this fatal flaw. I'm Eric with East Texas Homestead. I'm glad you're here. Let's jump right into it.
After unboxing everything, the first thing you're going to need to do is take the two metal plates and attach them to the back of the Chargeverter. Make sure that you have them flipped the right way. There's a little bit of an impression on one side that the screw fits flush into.
Now, it's really important that you make sure you're putting the Chargeverter onto something that is not going to catch on fire, which is why I'm using this Hardy Backer, because this thing gets screaming hot. And in the event there was an issue and it did catch on fire, you don't want to end up burning the place down. All right, so I've mounted this guy right here. It's actually pretty secure, not going anywhere. I put this piece, see if we can get back there and look. Woo, goes all the way back. All right, now that we've done that, we need to connect these guys. And they're gonna go over here. It's real important that your batteries are turned off and your battery breaker is turned off right here. Make sure between these two that you are not getting any voltage, because 48 volts will kill you. So with the old Chargeverter, I basically had the wires all over the place and they were really kind of difficult because they didn't follow the path of the rest of the wires. And so there, I had the Chargeverter sitting way up here and the wires going across, and it was just kind of a pain. When I'm not using this, it sits right here and the wires are gone. And when I need to use it, I just reach over here, grab my wires, clunk them in, and we're good to go. And whenever I'm done with them, push the button, slide them off, tuck them behind the cabinet, and they're out of the way. That's actually a pretty good selling point. You may be wondering, how on earth am I going to get this plug out to my generator? Because this is supposed to screw into your generator, right? That's the biggest drawback to both of these units. Now, the cool thing is, with this quick disconnect, you could actually rewire this to like a 40-foot cable and then just like run it through your door and stuff. But that's not the way we're going to do it. So we're going to run over here, plug this in. And just like that, the cable's on. This is not going to reach my generator. So what I've done right here is I've installed a NEMA L14 30 amp female receptacle that this is going to plug into. On the other side of the wall, we've got this guy right here, which is the MEL opposite end of what we just connected to, which allows me to plug this guy in, which then allows me to run an even longer cable out here, outside my barn, to my generator. Why am I going through this whole process of utilizing the Chargeverter instead of just utilizing the generator input on my inverters? And that's actually a really great question, and I'm glad you asked. But the answer is actually really important. So here's the deal. When we utilize the input on the generator right here, we're going directly from the generator to the inverter. We go, yeah, duh. But the problem is we're going directly from the generator to the inverter, and these generators put out a really dirty, nasty power. You see, this thing is capable of running at 6,500 watts, but when you get past about 3,000, the sine wave gets all choppy. Like, I almost like to envision it, and this is probably not super accurate, but I like to envision it just like the generator's like shaking apart. You know, I mean, you can just feel the crazy power of it just shaking all over the place. And that's kind of how your electricity is flowing through it as well. And this old tired power horse over here, it runs at 4,000 watts, but really anything over about 2,000, it starts getting nasty. So you might still be thinking, so what? Who cares about dirty power? Well, your inverter does. And from what I've heard from Signature Solar is that the number one cause of inverter failure is dirty power. So the Chargeverter sucks up all that dirty power and you can run at full bore on your generator. And then it converts the AC nasty dirty sine wave into a pure DC output that goes right at the proper voltage, nice and clean, into your batteries, keeping your inverters safe from the dirty power. If you're new to all of this, sometimes the NEMA 14, 30, 240, whatever it is, all the numbers get a little jumbled. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give you a link that you can check out, and I'm gonna give you all of these parts that I've used. Every single one of them, from this box to the adapters, to the cables, all of it. That way you don't have to fish through all of the options on your own like I did. The Chargeverter really is amazing, and it's something that is a must have if you're going to be charging your batteries from a generator. Now, if you're new to this sort of thing and you're thinking about building out an off-grid solar system, check out this video right here. This is our full build on the EG4 6000 XP. And this right here is the link that's gonna take you to all of the parts that we used to get this thing set up properly. Thanks again, I'm Eric. I'll talk to you on the next one.